Let's start the power manifestation session. Let's start with the Sadhguru Vandanam. Sit straight, visualize Bhagwan in the third eye, and let's start with the Sadhguru Vandanam. Nityanandam Paramasukadam Kevalam Jnanamurtim Vandvatitam Gagana Sadasham Tattvamasyadi Lakshyam Ekam Nityam Vimalamachalam Sarvadi Sakshi Bhutam Bhavatitam Trigunarahitam Sadgurum Tam Namami. Nityananda, welcome everybody. Such a beautiful space that Swamiji has created for all of us and initiated us into the most beautiful space. Every day, Bhagwan initiates us to the ultimate. Every word that he says literally enlightens us when we are ready. The most beautiful space that he is asking us to be in, avoiding to be in the reaction assumption mode. The constant pull of all our habits, our patterns, our incompletions, struggles, like how we have the solar system, we have layers and layers and layers of patterns and struggles and incompletion, which is pulling us towards it and putting us in an orbit of struggle, putting us in an orbit of pattern, putting us in an orbit of different things which we don't want. But the center, how the sun is constantly pulling and holding everything together, like that Paramashiva Swamiji himself has come down to hold us in the most beautiful inner space. Again and again, connecting him to the ultimate and connecting to him and experiencing the ultimate space inside you is the only way out. Again and again, going back to the space of Paramashanta. That again and again he's saying, that is the most valuable time. The reactions and whatever is happening outside avoids to be anything other than the illusion reaction. The delusion that we get into and the illusion reaction we get into is like continuous orbits which keeps on running our life. When we pull ourselves to the center, to the core of us, where the deep silence, which is much more powerful, Swamiji says, than the forces which are run by the patterns and other things. Only our decision is required. The beautiful decision, how we can start living in such a beautiful space of oneness with Paramashiva. More and more we cherish the space of Paramashiva. He says, literally in your throat, you can start really experiencing that nectar. If you have so much of anger and incompletion, you're going to feel so much of, literally the toxins in your tongue and toxins in your throat. Again and again, he says, the reaction assumption which are deluding us is the only problem. When we decide to let go of that, we deciding to be in only Paramashanta and be constant in action, continuously working, continuously contributing and sharing everything, all your experience, great experience, and not internalizing all these illusion and delusion. For that internalizing, we can internalize only Swamiji's words and simply hold him in the inner space and manifesting from his inner space, everything. He is manifesting your coffee. He is manifesting your thoughts. He is manifesting your decisions. Everything he is manifesting through you. Only that space is real. Again and again, Swamiji is giving us an initiation to experience that deep core of us, which is in Paramashanta space, which is more powerful, which can manifest everything much more clear, much more beautiful, much more in intelligent way than our reaction again and again. based on the patterns. The patterns are too feeble. Because we keep empowering them, it becomes very strong. If we let go whatever pattern we have and connect back to Paramashiva space in us again and again, such a beautiful oneness happens and everything what we want simply fall in place and gets into reality. The more we become reality, life becomes reality. Such an initiation that we have got. Let's go to the Shastra Pramana. Now we'll be playing the Shastra Pramana for today's sutra.
The Apta Pramana for the power of emitting divine fragrance is taken from the Hatha Yoga Pradipika, Sutra 71, Dharana 70. Divya Dehascha Tejasvi Divya Gandhastvaroghavan Sampurna Hridaya Shunya Arambhe Yogavan Bhavet Divya Dehascha Tejasvi Divya Gandhastvaroghavan Sampurna Hridaya Shunya Arambhe Yogavan Bhavet.
In the Arambha, the yogic body becoming divine, glowing, healthy and divine smell, the whole of his heart becomes void. Such a beautiful inner space when we hold. That's what Swamiji said. This fragrance of living in the space of oneness with Paramashiva is the ultimate fragrance from you. The grace, the beauty, the way you carry yourself in every action will be only in Paramashanta, simply manifesting your reality. More and more we are made of all the element, five elements, that is the earth, water, fire, air and ether. Continuously we are in the space of oneness with Paramashiva. We can master all these elements and we can start a really experience the higher consciousness, the higher level that is in us. Again and again, going back to the mind, going back to the thoughts, which is only deluding us. Whatever thoughts we have, whatever we are thinking is only delusion, Swamiji says. Such a beautiful thing. He once said, when we asked, Swamiji, don't you have thoughts? He said, yes, I have thoughts, but it's not the only thing which I have. You have 1 acre of thoughts and you are stuck there. I also have 1 acre of thoughts, but I have billions of space beyond that. So this 1 acre becomes very trivial. We have such an expansion possibility outside this box. And that will happen only when we are in the Paramashanta space to realize the ultimate source. The ultimate source is inside us and deep in the inner space. The more and more we start living in the Paramashanta space, more and more we go inward for solutions, we will have a breakthrough in everything. Everything what we do will be graceful, beautiful, just apt, just the decisions, everything will be just taking us to the next level of possibility. We don't have to struggle with life. We don't have to struggle with anything because we are not struggling with our thoughts. Only people who struggle with the thoughts, struggle with the delusion and illusion. Bhagavan says, we have to struggle with life. The more and more you are in oneness with Paramashiva, more and more you live the presence of Swamiji inside you, you will start seeing your life as ultimate celebration because he is manifesting exactly what you want in every decision, every thought and every action. More keeping to your center, more understanding the core of you, which is such a deep silence that you experience in your deep sleep every day without boredom and tiredness. Everyone goes to the deep sleep. We enjoy even the 5 minutes of it. And anybody's asked, what do you like the most? The best answer you can get from everybody is 5 minutes more sleep. And they enjoy that ultimate. If you wake up at 2 o'clock and you know you have 1 hour, 2 hours extra, you simply enjoy that as a biggest boon in your life. Such a joy happens even though we do every day, is because that is the Paramashanta space, not the deep sleep. But we can do experience much more when we are awake and when we decide to be in that silence. Swamiji says Kayakalpa has the best thing in the world because they are in the Mauna Mani. That means internal, no thoughts. You have zero thoughts inside you and you decide to be in that space and continuously hold Swamiji inside that void that is happening. That's what he says, the whole of his heart becoming void. Completely restful awareness, no awareness. Continuously deciding to be in that space makes you so graceful and start expressing the fragrance in you. Today we'll have the power of Surabhi. We'll post the instruction now. The power of Surabhi happens when you connect, contemplate on these great truths and you chant the Mahavakya, connecting to Paramashiva again and again. Let's sit straight. Visualize Bhagwan in the third eye with your back, neck and head in a straight line. Sit straight. Again and again, go back to the beautiful space of oneness with Paramashiva, the entanglement, the Shakti Pada, the initiation that you just received, in a deep silence and deep oneness space. Completely unclutched from the delusion and illusion, whatever is orbiting around you, do not get involved in that. Come to the center where Paramashiva resides like the sun and completely dissolve yourself, soak yourself in the deep prayer and gratitude with Swamiji and surrender to his lotus feet. Simply we will raise to the highest possibility again and again. That solves all the problem, even outside. Outside is not the resource. The inside is the resource. Swamiji beautifully guides us again and again, going back to the Mauna Mani, the silence inside us, the deepest part of us, where Swamiji resides in the deep silence and enjoying his bliss. Enjoying that bliss inside you is the ultimate bliss you can experience, Swamiji says. You are rebooted every night and you wake up in the morning as fresh. If you are rebooted, only if you have a sleep, we get into normalcy. Here, Swamiji beautifully takes us beyond that just by one initiation. Same way, the death, we'll understand when we are in the complete oneness with Paramashiva, not even death does anything to us. Simply holding that space again and again in the deep silence of you, Paramashanta space, liberates you from the thoughts and makes your reality extremely successful. So let's sit straight, get into the meditation, continuously chant the Mahavakya from the navel center. So it becomes the mantra to your Jatagni. Offering the mantra opens the Dadashanta in you and connects to the Paramashiva space and completely unclutch from this illusion and delusion. Continuously contemplate on what all Swamiji said today. Such a beautiful revelation that every day he comes and gives us the ultimate again and again for us. Just being contemplating on those great truths and constantly with a deep listening, continuously unbroken, is the beautiful word Swamiji has given. Each word you can celebrate when the avatar really happens in your life, that is when your listening is there. Simply it makes your life as real as possible. More and more connecting to Paramashiva, more and more unclutching and connecting and contemplating on these great truths and chanting the Mahavakya, Om Nityananda Paramashivoham, deeply and continuously. Hold that space and continuously chant.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Shivoham.
Shivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham
Nityananda
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् Yeah. शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द Namashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Such a beautiful space. So you can share your experience and beautifully how Swamiji says again and again, remembering how suppose some insect bites us and we go on scratching that place, make it worse and worse, instead of if we apply a little, no, a healing, it'll simply just disappear. Same thing. We have all these thoughts again and again coming to us and disturbing us. When we stop engaging ourselves, like Swamiji said, reactionary assumption, if we stop doing that and just unclutch from that few minutes, simply that will disappear. Holding that beautiful space and manifesting these great powers, go ahead and share all these with the world. Again and again, Swamiji beautifully says, sharing, enriching the world and sharing all this again and again with the world, the great manifestation powers and powerful cognition that Swamiji every day initiates so many of us, lakhs and lakhs of us. If we all share that beautiful space more and more with the world and again, understand this enriching is pulling us out of delusion. And literally, if you cause a person, that means you are liberated. Only if you cherish this Paramashanta space, simply other person will be caused. Holding that space and talking to anybody in, from that space, only cherishing Paramashiva in your inner space, not out of any fear or any greed, simply will manifest your reality. You will be living as Jivan Mukti, a living enlightenment, holding that beautiful space inside you, in a Paramashanta space. Again and again, Swamiji gives us this enriching causing as our daily routine to experience the liberations in us. He's waiting for each one of us to be liberated. That is the one and only goal for him, for us to get liberated from this delusion. And this, the death and birth cycle, he says death is going to be so easy. If you see the animals, if you live with animals, you know that animals don't die in front of so many monkeys live. And they don't die just like that. They go leave the body in a very remote place. Nobody can find. Even animals know their death space and even they don't leave their body in the public. If we live in that Paramashanta space, Swamiji says, simply we can just leave this and assume any body we want. Just rebooting our system, we know how it's easy to get an iPad. It's that easy to get another body. And just be born with Gurukul and be part of Gurukul. You can reboot yourself and come back to Gurukul. Or right now, you can be in Gurukul with as an Acharya and your Gurukul kids can still enjoy the beautiful space. We have online Gurukul all over the world. Swamiji's blessing for each and every child to experience this greatest bliss. Again and again, he gives this greatest opportunity. Every day he speaks about Gurukul because kids can really be liberated if they're given the science of living beyond the illusion and delusion and in the Paramashanta space, right from the engage, right from the womb. If you're pregnant or if you're having a baby of 1 year, from pregnancy to 21 years, you can enroll your child in Enlightened Kids. And if you want to be an Acharya, anybody 21 years and older to 120 years, anyone can register yourself in Acharya registration new. Again and again, he gives this beautiful space for us to experience the ultimate. Make sure you share the Living Enlightenment book the Gospel of Paramashiva Nityananda. Make sure you register and share this with as many groups as possible. Again and again, we request you. This is a very humble request from all of us to also be liberated. Share all these things and just call them for one satsang. Just let them come and experience one satsang, one meditation process, and let them see how many problems in their life just disappears and simply happens the way the reality they want. They can manifest any reality they want if they come for one satsang and start listening to Swamiji's satsang every day. It's the ultimate gift. You can give it to anybody to get them out of this delusion. Is the most valuable gift. So please share this with as many people, as many new groups as possible. That is the only gift that we can share, and we can experience that enlightened space. Whatever we enjoy, we will do that to the extreme. So let's do the Paramashanta space and share this beautiful book that Swamiji has written for just for us to be in living enlightenment to everybody possible. And that's a beautiful space. So let's surrender all the Shakti Swamiji has given today, and the initiation that he gave, and the powerful cognition, everything which has gone inside, as we understand, let's surrender all that to Swamiji's lotus feet. Anything and everything, good or bad, surrender to Swamiji's lotus feet. Simply, his lotus feet will guide us and empower us to more and more reality, the existential reality, and completely liberate us to the highest cognition. With a deep prayer, full space and gratitude, let's pray to Swamiji to make this as our existential reality. With that, let's visualize Bhagwan in third eye and end with the Purna Mantra. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purna Purnamudashyate Purnasya Purnamataya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Hari Om Tat Sat Sarvam Bhagavate Sri Nityananda Paramashivam Paduka Arpanamastu. Om Nityanandam. Nityanandam, and thank you so much. Make sure you are there for the next satsang and power manifestation session. Have a beautiful day, beautiful night. Thank you, Nityanandam.